Romans Review Part 4. Now we're going to review what we've learned so far in Romans chapter 8. Some of that, and one of the verses that we're going to talk about is verse 2. It's beautiful. That is, this verse explains the reason that there is no condemnation against us, none. For the law of the Spirit of life has set you free in Christ Jesus from the law of sin and death. Yes, we need to remember again and again that we are free from sin, period. That's why the verse above verse 2 is true. There is therefore now no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus. Hey, will there be condemnation against those who are in Christ ever? Never. Doesn't matter what happens to us, what terrible things, for example, sickness or broken relationships or addictions, loss of a job or divorce or depression. The list goes on and on. We can still depend on the truth. God has no condemnation against us. Never. But if Christ is in you, although the body is dead because of sin, the spirit is life because of righteousness. Praise God. No matter if our body's becoming old and dying, you know, and we're living in a broken world, we can still have joy. Why? Because God has no condemnation against us. Yes. And what's more, God has already conquered this world. Yes. Now we have future glory for eternity. For I consider that the sufferings of this present time are not worth comparing with the glory that is to be revealed to us. You who have trusted in Jesus Christ and are walking in the Spirit, remember that you have an ally, a friend, an ally living inside you. It's the Holy Spirit. He is with you, and He will help you to walk with the Lord and help pray for you when you don't know what to say. Likewise, the Spirit helps us in our weakness, for we do not know what to pray for as we ought, but the Spirit Himself intercedes for us with groanings too deep for words. And he who searches hearts knows what is the mind of the Spirit, because the Spirit intercedes for the saints according to the will of God. Paul, he's leaving the last part of Romans chapter 8 with questions and answers for us. What then shall we say to these things? If God is for us, who can be against us? Who shall bring any charge against God's elect? It is God who justifies. Who is to condemn? Christ Jesus is the one who died, more than that, who was raised, who is at the right hand of God, who indeed is interceding for us. No one can be against us when God is on our side. Let me close our review with Paul's final thoughts in chapter 8. We can rejoice in what he has to say. No, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am sure that neither death nor life, nor angels nor rulers, nor things present nor things to come, nor powers nor height nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. Coram Deo.